Hello everyone and welcome back to my channel. As promised, I am putting together the layout with the embellishments from my last video when I showed you how to do some print and cut and how to take those digital embellishments and make them a little bit more 3D. So everything on this layout is a digital file. It is all from the pizza party bundle at Kellybell Designs, and I am so grateful to have the opportunity to design for them now. And so I am going to combine the pizza party I had used. I have a wide format printer. It is a Canon TS9500 series. And I printed these out with my printer. I used just kind of I think it's an 80-pound cardstock, non-textured. It's a smooth cardstock, and printed these out and backed my photos. There's also a black that you can print out as well if you don't have black cardstock, so that I can back these photos as well. So these were taken our first day when we went to California. We headed to downtown Disney, and after our long day of travels, we were starving. And so we went to Naples and got some amazing pizza. And it was, I think, National Pizza Day recently. And so I wanted to go ahead and get that scrapbooked. I don't scrapbook chronologically, not even my trips, but this actually was on our first day, so there you go. So I am going to span this across both pages. When we do that, that adds a little bit of continuity to our pages, and so I just want that little element to go across the page. So what I'm going to do is go ahead and cut that off, and then I will line it up on the other side so that my photos are on there. So in my last video, I showed you that you can use the print and cut feature on Cricut, which I did, but you can also take these files and fussy cut them yourself. So you don't actually need to have a die cutting machine. It's certainly something you can do. And actually, before I had a Cricut, that's what I did with a lot of the files. So that's something that's definitely a possibility as well. One of the things that I really love, and I will link to the fan page and to the Kellybell page on Facebook, they are so, so wonderful about providing freebies. So if you want to just kind of check it out, and they coordinate. So one of the freebies that I'm going to be using is the title right there, that Naples. This is the restaurant that I ate at, or my husband and I did, and it goes so perfectly with this collection. And yeah, so that's just a feature that I really love that happens there. So now I'm going to be working on my clusters. Unfortunately, I dropped one of my pieces. I'm going to add in that title up at the top along with my journaling and just build my clusters up. So if you don't want to get the entire collection, there are always opportunities to get different elements from the collection. So maybe you just want the paper, or maybe you just want the embellishments, or over here I have a cut apart Project Life card. You don't have to get the whole set. And the really nice thing is, especially like the Project Life cards, they come in a PDF, and so it makes it really easy to just download it and print it. And the Project Life cards, I actually just cut apart with my paper trimmer. So I'm just going to add that as a little extra embellishment there, just to pull that yellow over a little bit more, and build up my clusters. So, like I was saying, in my last video and also with this video, it's so easy to use digital cut files or digital elements on your layouts. If you prefer to have a very flat album, this is certainly an option. You don't have to add any dimension to it, but it is also an option to go a little bit crazy and add some dimension as well. And I did show you last time, but I will kind of go over some of the things that I did to just add a little bit of dimension. Now, one of the things that you could do that I did not do in this particular one, you could pop these embellishments up. That is definitely a possibility. I just took a little bit of black ink and just inked the edges just to add a little bit of dimension to them, but you could actually pop the whole thing up. So now you'll see I have some of these other little embellishments or elements that I'm going to add to my photo. The one that I'm working with right this second, I had to trim off just a little bit of white. It was just a little bit off center when it cut. So I'm just going to find a happy little place for that to go. And I think I end up putting that on my photo. I was pretty good about getting people out of my layouts, but I do like to, I have a tendency to cover people up when I see them in my pictures. But that's just going to go center. And honestly, it's nice that it kind of draws your eye across. It's one more element. You'll see my embellishment clusters are at a diagonal. And that little embellishment on my pictures just kind of pulls your eye across the page. And that is something that I try to do with all of my designs, is make sure that there are reasons to pull your eye across the page so you're seeing the whole thing. So there's the flower that I embellished. I just took some glittery Nuvo drops and just added a cute little center to it. I'm using some of the little olive leaves just to add a little bit more of that pop of green and a little more interest. Now, I had also used some Nuvo drops on those as well, just to add a little extra dimension. All in all, this was a really fun layout. It went together very quickly. A lot of times I will speed up my process videos, and I'm leaving this one in real time because it just went together so quickly. And that's the wonderful thing about when you have these digital elements, everything matches. You don't have to look through your stash for extra stuff. You have all of the coordinating progress. All of the coordinating elements all together. And you'll see up there, I had made that into an epoxy flare by just using a little bit of dimensional glue from Ranger. And I added, you'll see there in that little flower, I added my Mickey head to the center with a little bit of Nuvo drops. And it just adds just a little extra pop. And makes it feel a little bit more 3D. So now I'm just going to work on that bottom cluster, and I absolutely adore these little Mickey pizzas. Oh my gosh. I mean, who doesn't love Mickey-shaped food? That's really kind of the whole reason that we go to the parks, right? I mean, the rides are nice and the characters and whatever, but the Mickey-shaped food, you guys, it's amazing. So I am going to take that little Mickey shaped pizza and I'm going to pull it off the edge a little bit. Again, that just kind of draws your eye, and it's just sort of a design trick that is really easy to do, and it just adds so much to the overall design of things. So now I'm trying to find a home for that other little black flower, but I thought, well, okay, I will figure out the leaves first, and then I will see what I can figure out. So I just wanted to also mention, if you have a chance to go over to the store, check out the bundle. It kind of highlights everything that is in each bundle, and I think you will be absolutely amazed. This, I used quite a few elements here, but literally, this is just a fraction of the things that are in the collection. And I think I had said in my last video too, these are yours, so you get to print them as many times as you want, you get to resize them, use them on different things. There are several elements here that I can use on lots and lots of different things. There's vegetables. I think this collection would be really good for the Remy's Adventure, the Ratatouille ride. Because there's vegetables and there's that cutter and there's a cutting board and just so many cool things. And now as I'm talking about that, I'm like, wow, you know what? I actually could do that. You can just kind of use a lot of different things in ways that maybe they weren't initially intended. You're kind of getting a lot of bang for your buck, which I think is amazing. Certainly when everything is super expensive, it's nice to have something that actually works for your money. And they have amazing sales as well. While I'm finishing up this cluster, I did want to remind you that if you like this video, make sure you hit that like button. If there are things that you would like to see, I am going to be working with this team and want to help you learn more about digital or hybrid scrapbooking. So if there are things that you just have questions about or would like to learn, leave me a comment. I would love to hear from you. As always, if you are not yet a subscriber, make sure you hit that subscribe button and the notification bell so that you are alerted to when I have new videos up. Again, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I will put the links to all of these products. And I hope you all have a magical day, everyone. Bye-bye.